Be seated. I want you to remember that no business has ever been successful by using hope as a strategy. They were successful because they were led by dynamic and experienced leaders who, after establishing their organizational vision, developed and executed a well-thought-out and deliberate strategy that protected and grew their current business, reduced their inventory and operating costs, resulting in increased profit margins and cash flows, and all the while taking an appreciable amount of market share away from their competition. We need to keep in mind that every battle is won before it is fought. Now, folks, all this stuff you hear from the liberal news media about the poorly run American business and about the American worker being lazy and not wanting to work is a lot of horse dung. Americans, traditionally, have always wanted to work. All real Americans have always had strong work ethics, and they've always wanted to be part of successful American companies. When you were kids and just getting started in your careers, you all admired Apple Computers, Ford Motor Company, Boeing Aircraft, Southwest Airlines, Google, and many others. Americans love a winner and will not tolerate a loser. American business leaders and workers play to win all the time. I wouldn't give a hoot in hell for any business leader who missed his budget and laughed or came up short and begged for government assistance, because the very thought of losing is shameful to Americans. Now, business is a team. In order for that team to be successful, it needs to work, train, and function as a team, and that starts with leadership. It is through that leadership that the combined efforts of everyone on that team will be in support of a well-communicated vision and deliberate strategy, where the actions across the entire organization required to execute the strategy are properly resourced and aligned, and it is understood that the entire team will be held accountable for the execution and outcome of those actions. It's also important to properly incentivize those who are responsible for preparing and executing the plan. Without the proper incentive program, some folks won't see the need to strive toward success when things get a little difficult, and you'll lose them along the way. And another thing, all this stuff you've heard about worker individuality from the talking heads on the boob tube and the internet is a bunch of BS. The people who talk and write about worker individuality for CNN and 60 Minutes don't know anything more about running a real business than they do about watching a football game. It's important to remember that for a business to be successful, it starts with leadership, with everyone on the team being on the same page, working together towards a common objective. Now, we have the finest facilities, equipment, technology, the best spirit, and the best workers in the world. You know, I actually pity some of our competitors and countries we're going up against. By God, I do. We're not just going to keep the business here in the U.S. We're going to do it while providing a higher quality product and do it with improved efficiencies and higher profit margins. We're going to keep that business here in the U.S. and we're going to bring more of it back home where it belongs. Now, I know some of you are wondering whether or not you'll trip and fall along the way. Don't worry about it. I can assure you that when the time comes, you will all do what is expected. Now, let's get started today. Start by taking the time and putting together your business strategy. Let's make the investments, the improvements, and the tough decisions today so we'll have a successful tomorrow. Now, there's another thing I want you to remember. We can't be successful in today's business by sitting back and maintaining our current position. We're not maintaining anything. Let the competition do that. We are improving our operations constantly, and we're not interested in holding on to anything except our profit margins and market share. We're going to excel in our strategic execution and take away his market share as we continue to expand our capabilities and our product offerings, all while putting more Americans back to work. Now, there's one thing you folks will be able to say when you retire, and you may thank God for it. 20 years from now, when you're sitting around your fireside with your grandchildren on your knee, and they ask you, what did you do during the Great Recession of the early 21st century, you won't have to say, well, I lost my job due to downsizing, watched my business shut down and the work moved overseas, and then lived on the government system. All right, now you people know how I feel, and you know exactly what needs to be done. Now is the time to take the fight to our competition, and may God have mercy on them, because I won't. And I will be honored to lead you wonderful folks in accelerating your business performance anytime, anywhere. That's all.